What's going on, everybody? My name is Kyle Welcher. Thank you for watching my videos. First and foremost, this week we're fishing James River. Look how close we are to Richmond. It's gonna be a fun week. Let's go. Good morning, everyone. It is officially day one of the Bassmaster Eastern Open on the James River. Practice was tough. We got about 40, maybe 50 waypoints. We didn't catch many off any of them, but we're going to run as many as we can run today. Try to catch us five good ones. The goal for today is 13 pounds. Anything over 10 and I'll be okay. Anything less than 10, I'm going to be pretty angry, but we're looking for a big bag. 13 to 17 would be awesome. That's going to be very, very difficult to get. I did catch some good ones in practice. Shook off a 4-pounder yesterday. So you never know what could happen. I'm not depending on that 4-pounder being back. But we're going to see. We're going to get out there. Give it all we can give it. Waiting in line now. Hopefully, this is going to be a good video. I'm not wearing the chesty today because it's just too much to fool with. You're in a tournament and I'm pretty high intensity when I'm fishing. So just going to have to see it from the dash. See y'all. Here's a big bass.
You got one?
Yeah. Yep, big bass.
Big bass.
Big bass.
What's it come off there, dude? I'm gonna lose this sucker.
What was that?
I should have swung him. I thought it was a little bit bigger.
Got one. God almighty.
Here we go.
That's not bad.
Kyle's got himself four. Oh, one shy of that five fish limit. But you're going to turn it around tomorrow, aren't you?
Yeah, no doubt. I'm running a long way and I'm making a lot of stops. It's feast or famine, and I got six bites today, only caught four of them.
And you got the right bites, man. You're around the right ones. 10 pounds, 5 ounces, double digits on four fish. Bring me five tomorrow.
Well, basically, day one, we sucked. Ended up with four fish for 10 pounds, 5 ounces. Had a good one. First fish of the day is a 4-pounder. Had a couple more 2.5s, and then I guess a 13-incher, about a 1-pounder. So basically, we sucked. Did kind of a high-risk thing. Tried to run the pattern all the way down to the Chickahominy, up in the Chickahominy some, run the tide all the way down to the Chickahominy, up in the Chickahominy some, and then back all the way back up the river. And I guess the areas I had found were not as good as I thought because I didn't catch any fish off of them. I thought that if I hit all the best stuff on the lake at the right tide, I would catch fish, and I just never did. I just struggled the whole time. So changing up for day two, we're going to stick in areas for longer. We're just going to sit there, fish the tides longer, pick the cover apart a little bit better, go a little more finesse. That's the plan anyway. He's going to try to make sure we catch five fish because the quality is actually not bad here. If you catch, you're catching mostly 2-pounders. You know, you catch five of those a day, you're pretty much going to get a check. So basically, a couple big bites on day two. It's going to be good. Just got to stay around the fish. That's what we did not do today. Did a ton of running. Barely made it back with just a tiny amount of gas. When we came under the drawbridge, which is about 15 or 20 miles south of launch, I thought for sure I was going to run out of gas. I did not think I had enough. So, wasn't so bad though. Made it back. Barely. Only got four fish though. So tomorrow, day two, we got to make it a lot better. Got to stay in good areas. Got to catch us five. Let's go get it done. I'm thinking I need 11 pounds to get a check and 15 pounds to make the top 12. Don't know for sure. Just knowing traditionally, historically, it's took about 20 and a half pounds to get a check and 25 pounds to make the top 12. So that's the goal.
Last call, play number one.
Day two, we started off running quite a bit of new water. That's what I do a lot when I struggle on day one. You can see here we have absolutely no fish in the live well. We've had two bites, didn't capitalize on either one of them. This is almost 11 o'clock. We do in at 2:15 and we have zero fish. So we're going a little bit more finesse on this low tide around these docks. That was a fight, dude, to get him.
I seen him in there over the top. Got one on?
Yep.
Oh yeah. Good one too.
Stay on there, dude. Stay on there. Stay on there. Stay on there.
Right.
too.
It's late, but it's starting, I guess.
It's a keeper.
Yep, that's a keeper.
Freaking broke off.
So after getting a few bites on docks, I decided to stay in the Chickahominy and fish docks until literally I had no extra minutes to make it back to check in. But after fishing the last 20 or so docks, I didn't get any bites at all. So we decided to go back 15 minutes earlier and hit one little creek where the tide's going to be right by check in. God, dude.
Oh, dude.
What a good freaking call to leave down there. Oh. 215.
Good job. Fourth place right now with 24-1. We'll see if that holds up.
Well, not the tournament day anymore, but 13-12 on day two. We did what we needed to do. We moved up from 68th to 25th, I think is what we ended in. So moved up in points. I don't know what it was before this, but I know I'm in 11th now. Only reason I looked that up because I want to see if it was mathematically possible to make the elites. Next one's on Oneida in probably about a month, and I don't think it's possible to make the top five, which qualifies for the elites. just based on how many points I have to make up. It could be possible we're going to go to Oneida and try anyways, because there could be some shaking up. So we're going to go try anyways, but don't know if it's going to be possible. Anyways, right now I'm moving to 11th. Not bad. Day one was really disappointing for this tournament. I thought I was on them pretty decent. I know you can't tell by our practice, but I thought I was actually on them pretty decent. So day one was awful. Day two, caught them better, 13-12. Still had some mishaps, throwing 8-pound tests under these docks with barnacles on it. You're going to break some off from time to time. So that's what happened, and glad I caught me five. Literally, I left the Chickahominy at 116. If anybody doesn't know, it's about a 40-mile ride to get back from the Chickahominy to weigh in. So it took me about 40 minutes. It was like 155 when I pulled up to that last creek. I had to check in at 215. By the time I got in the creek and fished around a little bit, I caught my fourth fish, my fourth keeper's at like 201. I go back in that cut, turn around and come back out. At like 207, I catch a 4-pounder. Boom. Throw them in live. Oh, that's my fifth fish. So I got a 13-incher in there. Next cast, catch a 2.25 and cull out the 13-incher. That's at 208. I got to check in at 215. And at 2 o'clock, I had three fish for about 6.5 pounds. Unbelievable end to the tournament day. Got back to weigh in, and I was actually excited. I'm almost never excited. Even weighing in 22, 23 pounds, I'm never, like, smiling and happy. But because my adrenaline was still pumping from catching those fish literally 10 minutes ago, I was excited to get back to weigh in and weigh those fish in. I knew I was getting out there with a check. I knew I was going to have a decent finish. So that was all good. Anyways, hope you liked the video. As always, leave a like, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button. I appreciate y'all that's been around for a while. I appreciate y'all, the new guys as well. Any questions, comments you got, let me know down below. I will see y'all at Oneida, I guess.